was erected then. It was an altar. Well over 4 years, almost 4 years, rather, well over 3 years. Every morning, Monday to Friday, this man will be there. He will come to his office early. He will be praying, standing at the rooftop, facing the ocean, the babish. We'll be praying. He was servicing an altar. You must have an altar that you are servicing. By the grace of God, this hour of mercy is an altar that God has erected for well over a year. 12 noon to 1 p.m., 12 midnight to 1 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. It's an altar. So we need to raise altar to counteract the altars of the devil that has been erected against you. Until, you know, since the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violence take it by force. God asked Gideon to go to his father's house and put down the Asherah poles in his father's house and put down the altars of Baal in his father's house. Today I decree the Asherah poles of your father's house shall be crumbled in the mighty name of Jesus. The altar of Baal in your father's house, in your in-law's house, they will crumble this morning. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Lift up your voice, say every altar speaking evil against my manifestation. Crumble by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Every altar erected against my glory, crumble by fire. I pull you down in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray. I pull down every altar erected against my glory in the mighty name of Jesus. You wicked altar, crumble by fire. Every wicked altar from my father's house, from my mother's house, from my in-law's house, I command you, crumble by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Every wicked altar, I command you in the name of Jesus, crumble by fire, crumble by fire, crumble by fire. Every wicked altar in the name of Jesus, crumble by fire, crumble by fire. Every wicked altar in the name of Jesus, crumble by fire. Every wicked altar in the name of Jesus, I command you, crumble by fire, 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 crumble by fire. Every wicked altar, every evil altar raised against my glory in the name of Jesus, I pull you down. Has Gideon pulled down the Asherah poles of his father's house? Has Gideon pulled down the demonic altars of his father's house? I pull you down in the mighty name of Jesus. I come in the spirit of Gideon. I pull down every Asherah pole in my father's house. I come in the name of Jesus. I pull down every Asherah pole in my mother's house. I come in the name of Jesus. I pull down every Asherah pole erected against my ministry. I come in the name of Jesus. I pull down every Asherah pole erected against my life in the mighty name of Jesus. Every wicked altar crying no to my testimony in the name of Jesus. You are silenced by the blood of the Lamb. Every wicked altar saying no to my testimony, you are silenced by the blood of the Lamb in the mighty name of Jesus. Every satanic altar saying no to my testimony, you are silenced by the blood of the Lamb in the mighty name of Jesus. Every satanic altar saying no to my testimony, you are silenced by the blood of the Lamb in the mighty name of Jesus. Every ungodly altar saying no to my testimony, you are silenced by the blood of the Lamb in the mighty name of Jesus. Every satanic altar saying no to my testimony, you are silenced by the blood of the Lamb in the mighty name of Jesus. Every demonic altar saying no to my testimony, you are silenced by the blood of the Lamb in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil altar crying no to my testimony, you are silenced by the blood of the Lamb in the mighty name of Jesus. Every wicked altar denying me of my peace, you are destroyed by fire. Every altar robbing me of my peace, you are destroyed by fire. Every altar robbing me of my peace, you are destroyed by fire. Every altar robbing me of my peace, you are destroyed by fire. Every altar robbing me of my peace, you are destroyed by fire. Every altar robbing me of my peace, you are destroyed by fire. Every altar robbing me of my peace, you are destroyed by fire. Every altar robbing me of my peace, you are destroyed by fire. in the mighty name of Jesus. Your hand has come in the name of Jesus. Your hand has come, every altar, every wicked altar, deny me of my peace. Your hand has come in the mighty name of Jesus. Your hand has come in the mighty name of Jesus. Every altar hindering me from progressing in life, your hand has come in the mighty name of Jesus. I plead the blood of the Lamb against every evil altar, speaking against my glory in the mighty name of Jesus. I plead the blood of the Lamb against every Asherah pole, seeking against my glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray this morning. Lift up your voice and pray. Lift up your voice and pray. Lift up your voice and pray. I plead the blood of the Lamb against every satanic altar, speaking against my glory in the mighty name of Jesus. I plead the blood of the Lamb against every ungodly altar, speaking against my glory in the name of Jesus. I plead the blood of the Lamb against every evil altar, speaking against my glory in the name of Jesus. I plead the blood of the Lamb against every satanic altar, speaking against my glory in the mighty name of Jesus. I plead the blood of the Lamb against every evil altar opposing my destiny. Be consumed by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Be consumed by fire. 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 Every mobile altar erected against my glory. Every mobile altar monitoring my progress. Every mobile altar monitoring my ministry. Be consumed by fire. Be consumed by fire. Be consumed by fire. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Mobile altars are individuals or animals. Mobile altars are individuals or animals that follow people around to do them evil. I don't know how many of you know that movie titled Evil Encounter by Jimmy Odumosu. Anytime that woman or anybody in that family sees that evil dog, something bad must happen that day. Few minutes after, something bad must happen. It is the ministry of evil altar for you to have a dream and something bad will follow. It is ministry of evil water. Today, you are delivered. Today, you are delivered. Today, you are delivered. In the mighty name of Jesus. Have you ever wondered why God decided to kill all the male firstborn, all the firstborn in Egypt, all the first male sons in Egypt? Have you ever wondered why? It is simple. God decided to place judgment against the mobile altars of Egypt. Every male firstborn in the land of Egypt was a mobile altar. In the days in ancient Egypt, anytime a male child is born, particularly the first male child of a family, from the moment the baby is brought from the blood, in between the legs of the mother, from the moment the baby is brought, without being cleaned up, the baby will be placed between magicians, chronic witch doctors. The baby will be surrounded by witch doctors of the land of Egypt. They begin to pour enchantment and incantation on that baby. They pour the spirit of Egypt upon that child. After hours, they see some manifestation and they let the baby go. Years later, when the baby is about 3, 4, 5 years old, if anything is needed, maybe they need information from the past or from the future. They want to know what happened 800 years before or what will happen 800 years into the future. They will bring that baby into a gathering, and the witch doctors, the wicked powers of Egypt, the herbalists of Egypt will surround that baby. They begin to pour enchantment and incantation on that child. After a while, that spirit will possess the child. The child will begin to speak as he's speaking in tongues. The baby will begin to speak as he's speaking in tongues. I'm not sure what you have been paying attention. The baby will begin to speak as he's speaking in tongues. Then suddenly, before you know it, my brothers, my sisters, that baby will go into the spirit and will begin to speak that evil language. So any information, any question they ask that child about what has happened years before, hundreds of years before, or what will happen on years into the future, the baby will give accurate answer. So every male child, particularly first male child in the land of Egypt, was a mobile altar. So when God decided to kill all the male firstborn in Egypt, God decided to kill all the mobile altars that were moving all over the land of Egypt, gathering information being used for the enslavement of generations of people. 11 generations of people, a generation is 40 years. For 430 years, 11 generations were enslaved. None of them thought about moving. Ministry of mobile altars. Today, every mobile altar in your life shall receive the sword of heaven. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh Lord, arise. In your mighty power, bring an end to my sorrow. Wipe away my tears. Oh Lord, arise. In your mighty power, bring an end to my sorrow. Wipe away my tears. Holy Ghost, arise. Your mighty power, bring an end to my sorrow. Wipe away my tears. Messiah, arise. In your mighty power, bring an end to my sorrow. Wipe away my tears. Jehovah, arise. In your mighty power, bring an end to my sorrow. Wipe away my tears. Jesus, arise. In your mighty power, bring an end to my sorrow. Wipe away my tears. Holy Ghost, arise. In your mighty power, bring an end to my sorrow. Wipe away my tears. Jesus, arise. In your mighty power, bring an end to my sorrow. Wipe away my tears. Lift up your voice. Say, mighty Jehovah, arise in your power. Bring an end to my sorrow. Wipe away my tears. Strike down every evil altar erected against my testimony. In the mighty name of Jesus, strike down every evil altar erected against my joy. In the mighty name of Jesus, strike down every evil altar erected against my victory. In the mighty name of Jesus, mighty Jehovah, arise in your mighty power. Strike down every evil altar erected against my glory. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray. Lion of the tribe of Judah, arise and strike down every evil altar, every mobile altar operating against my destiny. Be struck down by fire. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Numbers 23:13-14. Then King Balak told him, come with me to another place. There you will see another part of the nation of Israel, but not all of them, cause at least that many. So Balak took Balaam to the plateau of Zophim on Pisgah peak. He built 7 altars there and offered a young bull and a ram on each altar, because a people of God were about to be cursed. A priest with mixed anointing was hired to curse the children of God. And here they went to a very strategic mountain, climbed the top of that mountain, the plateau of Zophim on the Mount of Pisgah peak. They climbed it where they could have a very good view of majority of the people of God who were innocently going about their activities. And 7 altars were built as strategic places on the mountain. And on every altar, a young bull and a ram on each altar. A young bull and a ram. 14 animals, 2 per altar, were slaughtered just because a nation was about to be cursed. Just because a nation was about to be cursed. Beloved, Balak hired Balaam to curse the nation of Israel. Only God knows how many people have been hired to afflict your life. It will not fail. It will not stand. I say it will not stand. It will not stand. Every plan to afflict your life will fail. Every plan to afflict your life will fail. Every plan to afflict your life will fail. In the mighty name of Jesus, every plan to afflict your life will fail. Every demonic altar raised for your sake. In the name of Jesus, every evil priest hired for your sake, will be scattered by the fire of God in Jesus' name. Will be scattered by the fire of God in Jesus' name. Beloved, glory be to God. We have a God who is far greater than them. And his word never fails. The word of Jesus never fails. He has power to give us victory. I decree and declare upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will checkmate every altar erected for your affliction. I say, mighty Jehovah shall arise. He will checkmate every altar erected for your affliction. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your voice, Holy Ghost, arise. Checkmate every altar erected for my affliction. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Lord, arise. Checkmate every altar erected for my affliction. Mighty Jehovah, arise. Checkmate every altar erected for my affliction. Spirit of the living God, arise. Checkmate every altar erected for my affliction. Holy Ghost, arise. Checkmate every altar erected for my affliction. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lion of the tribe of Judah, arise. Checkmate every altar erected for my affliction. Lily of the valley, arise. Checkmate every altar erected for my affliction. Lion of the tribe of Judah, arise. Checkmate every altar erected for my affliction. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. The nation of Israel did not know that an evil priest had been hired to destroy them. You are going to pray. Every Balaam that has been hired to curse me, receive the blood of Jesus in the mighty name of Jesus. Every altar, every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray. Every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb. Go into divine confusion in the mighty name of Jesus. Every altar erected to afflict me, receive the blood of the Lamb. Go into divine confusion in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray. Every altar, every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb. Go into divine confusion in the mighty name of Jesus. Every Balaam hired to afflict me, receive the blood of the Lamb. Go into divine confusion in the mighty name of Jesus. Every Balaam hired to afflict me. Every Balaam hired to stop me. Every Balaam hired to curse me. Receive the blood of the Lamb. Go into divine confusion in the mighty name of Jesus. By the blood of the Lamb, be silent forever. Every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb and be silent forever. Every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb and be silenced forever. Receive the blood of the Lamb and be silenced forever. Every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb, be silenced forever. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb, be silenced forever. Receive the blood of the Lamb, be silenced forever. Every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb, be silenced forever. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb, be silenced forever. Every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb, be silenced forever. Every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb, be silenced forever. Every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb, be silenced forever. Every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb, be silenced forever. Every Balaam hired to curse me, receive the blood of the Lamb, be silenced forever. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. You are going to pray in the name of Jesus. Isaiah 7:7 says, it will not stand, neither shall it come to pass. It will not stand, neither shall it come to pass. You are going to pray. Every evil pronouncement against my glory, you will not stand, you will not come to pass. In the mighty name of Jesus, every evil pronouncement against my glory, every evil pronouncement upon any altar against my glory, any altar in the sea, any altar on the mountains, any altar on the land, any altar in the air, any altar wherever whatsoever, that evil word has spoken against me. In the name of Jesus, be silenced by fire. Be silenced by fire. Every evil word issued against me upon any altar, you will not stand, you will not come to pass. In the mighty name of Jesus, every evil word issued against me upon any altar, you will not stand, you will not come to pass. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will not stand, you will not come to pass. Every evil word working against my glory, be nullified by fire. Lose your power, lose your power, lose your power, lose your power. Every evil word released against my destiny, lose your power. In the mighty name of Jesus, lose your power. Every curse blocking the way to my greatness, lose your power, lose your potency. Every curse blocking the way to my greatness, lose your power. In the mighty name of Jesus, every curse blocking the way to my greatness, lose your power, lose your power, lose your power, lose your power, lose your power. Every curse blocking the way to my greatness, lose your power. In the name of Jesus, every evil word blocking the way to my greatness, lose your power, lose your power, lose your power. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice and pray. Every evil curse blocking the way to my greatness, lose your power in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil curse blocking the way to my greatness, lose your power in the name of Jesus. Every evil curse blocking the way to my greatness, lose your power in the name of Jesus. Every evil curse blocking the way to my greatness, lose your power. Every cause of poverty, cause of stagnation, cause of failure against my destiny, backfire by fire, 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 backfire by fire. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Every evil sacrifice rendered against me, torn against your honor, torn against your honor. Every evil sacrifice, every evil altar raised against me and my family, turn against your honor in the mighty name of Jesus. Turn against your honor now. Every evil altar, every evil sacrifice rendered against my destiny, rendered against my ministry, rendered against my marriage, turn against your honor, 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 turn against your honor. Turn against your owner, 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 in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray. Turn against your owner, turn against your owner. Every wicked altar erected against me, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, turn against your owner. Every satanic altar erected against me, turn against your owner in the name of Jesus. Turn against your owner. Every satanic altar erected against me, I command you in the name of Jesus, turn against your owner in the mighty name of Jesus. Turn against your owner. Every wicked altar erected against me in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, turn against your owner. Every satanic altar erected against me, I command you in the name of Jesus, turn against your owner in the mighty name of Jesus. Turn against your owner in the mighty name of Jesus. Turn against your owner. Every evil altar erected against me, turn against your owner in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Every altar of Balaam raining curse on me, you wicked altar, be destroyed by the power of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Every altar of Balaam raining curse against my destiny, you wicked altar, be destroyed by the power of God. Lift up your voice and pray. Every Asherah pole, every altar of Baal, every altar of Baal, every altar of Balaam, erected against my glory, be destroyed by the power of God. In the mighty name of Jesus, be scattered by fire, be scattered by fire, be scattered by fire, be scattered by fire, be scattered by fire. Be scattered by fire. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. We are pulling down stronghold. We are pulling down stronghold. We are pulling down stronghold in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, pulling down stronghold. We are pulling down stronghold. We are pulling down stronghold in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, pulling down stronghold. We are pulling down stronghold. We are pulling down stronghold in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, pulling down stronghold. We are pulling down stronghold. We are pulling down stronghold in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, pulling down stronghold. You are pulling down stronghold. We are pulling down stronghold in the name of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, pulling down stronghold. We are pulling down stronghold. We are pulling down stronghold in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, pulling down stronghold. We are pulling down stronghold. We are pulling down stronghold in the name of the Lord. I decree and declare upon your life, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, let every stronghold of the devil against your destiny collapse. In the mighty name of Jesus. I dip my lips in the blood of the Lamb. I decree and declare in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that every stronghold of the devil against your glory will collapse. Oh, I command them to collapse. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Luke 5:8-10. Luke 5:8-10. Simon Peter, when he saw it, fell to his knees before Jesus. Master, leave. I am a sinner. I can't undo this holiness. Leave me to myself. When they pulled in, that's the Message translation. When they pulled in the catch of fish, all overwhelmed Simon and everyone with him. It was the same with James and John, Zebedee's son, co-workers of Simon. They could not undo the holiness of Christ. They could not undo the holiness of Christ. I want to assure you that the key against every demonic altar is holiness. Holiness is a strong key to the miraculous. Holiness will keep any demon away. Holiness destroys the works of the enemy in our lives. Holiness brings the presence of God into our environment. Holiness will bring the impossible to you. Now the question is it possible for you to be holy? I want to put it to you, yes, it is. For as long as you desire it, the key is your desire. Once you desire it, God will only give you the things that you desire. Psalm 37 verse 4 says, he will grant the desires of our heart. Once you desire it, you will surely win. Once you live a holy life, you need the key to total victory over the Asherah poles, over the altars of balance, over the altars of Baal in your life is a life of holiness. It is not within our power as human beings, but once we desire it, God will impart the grace. Lift up your voice, say, Lord, I receive the hunger for holiness. I receive the thirst for righteousness. The Bible says that blessed are those who thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Today, I receive the thirst for righteousness. I receive the hunger for righteousness. In the mighty name of Jesus, I depend on you. I receive the grace to live holy. I depend on you. I receive the grace to live holy. I depend on you. I receive the grace to live holy. Whatever is in me that is not holy, uproot it now in the name of Jesus. Whatever is in me that is not holy, uproot it now in the name of Jesus. Whatever is in me that is not holy, uproot it now in the name of Jesus. Whatever is in me that is not holy, uproot it now in the name of Jesus. Whatever is in me that is not holy, uproot it now in the name of Jesus. Whatever is in me that is not holy, uproot it now in the name of Jesus. Whatever is in me that is not holy, uproot it now in the name of Jesus. Whatever is in me that is not holy, uproot it now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty Jehovah. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Mighty Jehovah, we thank you. There is no one like you. We worship you. We honor you today. We come to you. We ask, oh Lord, that you will pull down every Asherah pole, every altar of Baal, every altar of Balaam, every wicked altar, every demonic altar erected against our glory in the name of Jesus. We run into your name. We run into your name. Eternal Rock of Ages. We run into your name. Oh, we run into your name. We run into your name, eternal rock of ages. We run into your name. We run into your name, Baba. We run into your name, eternal rock of ages. We run into your name. Oh God of the hour of mercy, we run into your name. The Bible says the name of the Lord is a mighty tower. The righteous run into it and is saved. The word of the Lord says, as the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his own people. We run into this prayer mountain. We run into the hour of mercy. Oh Lord, preserve us in Jesus' name. Pull down every evil altar erected against our destiny. Silence the voices of evil altar. Return arrows from evil altars to sender. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let every altar erected against our glory begin to turn against their own owner. In the mighty name of Jesus. Arise, O Lord. Defend your investment in our lives. Let your name be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I want to thank you for joining the hour of mercy. By the grace of God, we shall meet again at 12 noon. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Ghost dwell and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Shalom. Peace in Jesus' name.